Yo, 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 yo. Yo, this is a walk and talk. This is a walk and talk. But this one right here, guys, this video right here is gonna give you the secrets to marketing, the secrets to advertising, the secrets to writing words, creating ads, making Shopify stores, making products that make money, that actually get people to pull out their credit cards and to pay you their money. This is gonna make you a money magnet. So much bullshit out there. There's so much this, that, drop shipping, TikTok shop, dance around. Okay, no, but for real, guys, these two concepts are basically a summary. It's not that everything else is wrong. It's just like so much rests back upon these two ideas. And they're two quotes that stick out to me from thousands of hours of studying copywriting, from obsessing, losing my mind in the pages of direct response, in the pages of e-commerce, in hours of consuming content. Thousands of hours. Okay, enough beating around the bush. The reason these quotes will make you money is because this is what you actually focus on. This is where you put your focus. There's so much noise. And if you don't get these things straight and work on these things, then it's all a waste of time. The pretty designs and the long email that you think is, you know, really good, and then nobody buys anything, and the brand you start, and then nobody cares. Okay? It's because you ignored these things. So let's start with the first one. Let's start with the first and foundational thing. And you know what? This is actually gonna be a relief to you, because you know what? The people who make a shit ton of money, they're focusing on this, and they're not focusing on all that other stuff that doesn't make money. So this is from Gary Halpert. The book is called The Bore on Letters, and you should read it for sure. But the quote, the first thing he starts. So I get out this book. I'm like, this is the greatest copywriter of all time. What's the secret? What's he gonna tell? He's writing these letters to his son. What's he gonna tell him about how to make all this money by just writing, by writing these letters and sending them out to people? And he writes, "Dear Bond," his son's name is Bond, and he's writing, he's in jail, and he's writing, "Dear Bond, if you wanna make all the money," or however he starts it, "then here's what you need to do." Suspense. You need to become a student of markets. Period. You need to become a student of markets. What does that mean? Because at first I read that, I'm like, no, what's like the copywriting trick? What's the way of writing? What's like the hack? This is what he starts with. You need to become a student of markets. And what this means, and why this is so foundational, is because the market, the power of the market, is what creates all the sales. You just funnel that as a copywriter and as a business owner and as a brand builder and as a Facebook ad maker. You just funnel that power of the market. But the power of the market is already there. You just have to be a steward and a catalyst and a technician of how to catch that, the force of that market. So when he says become a student of markets, he means, where are the desires? Where are the ways that people are thinking? Where are the ways that people are needing something? Where are the movements of the market? Think of it like a tsunami wave. Think of a absolutely, you know, monumental wave, the power of that wave, the power of that trend. And I'm not talking like little trends like, oh, it was trending on TikTok for 3 days. No, I'm talking about like millions of people in the world realizing that they need to become more healthy. I'm talking about millions of people realizing that, you know, seed oils are bad for them. I'm talking about, you know, billions of people realizing that self-improvement and starting business and you know, having more control over your life, and that there's ways to do this online. You know, these massive moves where people are moving in a direction. That's what happens when you become a student of markets. You study this, you realize this, and you realize that to harness that power for your business, you need to be aware of that wave, and you need to be aware of the wave that your business pertains to, because the way you fail is when your business doesn't pertain to it at all. Or maybe it does, but you don't position it in the right way. So you totally miss, you totally don't get a surf at all. You just like you're like paddling in the wrong direction, literally. And so to become a student of markets means to understand what is going on in the market and in the different areas of the market. What people are buying, what people are wanting, what problems people are trying to solve. Because from another great book, there's another quote, Eugene Schwartz from Breakthrough Advertising, which you should also read. And in that he talks about, we don't create desire as copywriters and as marketers, we just channel it. And it's the same thing. We're just picking the words and we're picking the phrases and we're picking the positioning to channel that desire. Think of a magnifying glass focusing the power of the sun onto a little dry leaf, and then it, you know, you get that flame. It burns. It gets hot. That's what we do. We can't make a sun. And so that's why I say where this might be a relief. It's like you don't have to come up with the power of the market. You just have to observe and study it. You have to be a student of the market. And that might sound annoying, and you're like, I don't know how to do that. And it's like, well, you probably already do it, first of all. You probably do it without realizing it, because you realize that there's a trend in a certain direction. You start to see that people are they want to make money online. You see like someone like Andrew Tate, you see this move towards masculinity, this push back against, you know, that it's all like toxic masculinity. You see these things. You listen to these podcasts, you listen to this content, you see these waves. And now you just need to realize that, oh yeah, I'm becoming a student of the market, and I'm realizing there's a movement towards something. There's movement towards content. There's movement towards knowledge. And then ultimately there's movement towards products that give people what they want, the desired outcome, right? What they're looking for. So that is number one. And rewind this a minute or two if you want, or whether you want to or not, you probably should, because you're gonna wanna skip over that. Sounds, oh, it's the boring part. This is how you win. This is how you make sales. This is how you do it. Student of markets. Part two, equally as important, is another quote from a guy called, okay, I'm going to forget this guy's name, but he's another great copywriter, another great marketer. And his advice for copywriters, people writing ads, is to enter, I think it's Clayton McPeace. I think that's his name. But his advice is to, he says you should enter the conversation that your prospect is already having in their own head. That might not be perfect, but it's pretty much that. The quote is, you need to enter the conversation that the prospect is already having in their own head. What does that mean? Well, it's the same as before, where you have to understand the market, but this time you need to understand the person, the prospect, the problems, desires, the thoughts that they're literally having on a daily basis. The person who wants to lose weight and they're thinking, I'm insecure, I don't look the way I want to look. Oh, there's my crush, but they think I look fat. Like the insecurities. Oh, if only I could lose this weight. Imagine I could lose this weight in 6 months, and they start to picture it. Oh, I'd be fit. I'd look good in that t-shirt. I'd be more sexy. Maybe I'd have a chance then. These are all the conversation in their head. That is your copy. Your copy literally enters that. How would you like to drop 30 pounds in the next 6 months without starving yourself and without running? You start, you know, what if you had a proven plan to finally stop being insecure about your weight and your body? Eat the foods you like. I'm just making this up. Eat the foods you like and have your dream body and outcome. Well, might sound too good to be true. It's not. Here's Dave. 9 months ago, Dave was 50 pounds overweight and he hated himself. So it sounds corny and it sounds cheesy, but this is what writes the copy. Like, this is more important than, there's all the formulas and stuff, and that stuff's all good, but if you don't know the conversation your prospect's having in their own head, how can you write the ads? How can you write the copy? How can you write the emails that is going to resonate with their little points of desire and their little points of pain? Because that's what you want to do. You want to meet them in their pain, affirm the pain, and then walk with them with your copy towards the solution. And that is how you write brilliant. That is how you do brilliant marketing. This is what makes good content as well, by the way. And it is easier said than done, but this is how you do it. And this is why ads don't work. Like, when people's ads don't work and nobody gives a shit about their brand or their product, and they're like, why is nobody buying it? It's like, well, they don't care. You're not in the conversation in their head. You haven't entered into their plane of existence and the things that they are concerned with. Instead, you're trying to list things that they don't care about at all. So this takes some thought, and this is helpful always if you're your own market or if you have been your own market. Because just think about it. Think about yourself right now. Let's take you. Watching this video, maybe you want to start an e-commerce brand. Maybe you want to become a freelance copywriter. Maybe you hate your job. You're sick of making this bullshit $17 an hour for this boss who just, like, you have no freedom. You can't buy the stuff you want. You wish you could help your parents out with their mortgage payment, all this stuff. And it's like, well, what if you have what it takes right now and you can just learn this one skill set that's going to pay you $7,000 a month to write some words on your laptop from home? And there's people dumber than you doing this right now. How would that sound? Sound too good to be true? Here's Dave. He's Dave again. Dave learned how to do email copywriting, and now he spends, instead of 40-hour weeks, he spends six hours a week writing a few emails, and he makes $7,000 a month from wherever he wants. You know, you got to enter the conversation that people are having in their own head. Let's look at Andrew Tate again as an example, and Hustlers University and all that stuff. Of course, these young guys want to be killers. They don't want to listen to the lame 40-year-old teacher's overweight and hates her job. They want to listen to the ripped badass who smokes cigars and drives supercars and says, listen, if you want to be, like, how can you as a man just sit there and be broke? Like, you know, he makes fun of them for being broke. And that resonates because the conversation deep within their head is, this school, this class is bullshit, and I should be doing something better with my life. And I know I'm more than this, and I need someone to challenge me. And I can learn, I can build something. And not only that, but, like, I should do it. And then Tate speaks exactly to those things. Same thing with Jordan Peterson. Why did he blow up? Pretty simple stuff. Brilliant dude, obviously. But I just mean the things he talked about. Well, your life's a mess. Well, why don't you start putting things in order? And if you get overwhelmed, why don't you start smaller? Like, why not make your bed? And don't underestimate making your bed. And what if you put something else in order the next day? And what if you aimed upward? We don't know what the upper potential of that could be. And you did that again for a year. Who would that person be? And it's worth writing down, you know, all this stuff that you're like, oh, that's a good idea. He enters the conversation you're having in your head, which is, why am I not improving my life? I know I can improve my life. I know I deserve more. I know I want more. What are the small practical things? What's, show me the proven path. And then he talks to that. So now I'm rambling a little bit, but this is it, guys. So that is the second piece, to enter the conversation they're having in their head. And you do this with the copy, but you do this with the images. You do this with the social media posts. You do this with the products that you create. And that's how you do it, guys. So that is what I want to share. This, honestly, this is the sauce. This is the sauce. The Facebook ad stuff, it's like technical, just set up an ad, but like the creative, the messaging, the emails, that is where you need to really know and understand the shit, and you can't just parrot it. Because if you just copy someone, it doesn't work. It does not work. I've had people copy me, and you take inspiration, guys, but if you don't understand why they're doing it or why they're writing it, you're going to sound like a dumbass. So learn it yourself. Start to feel the resonance. And it will be corny at first, and you won't get it perfect. And I don't get it perfect, but like, you will start to understand what resonates. And that's where you can get those first fans, those first customers, those first people who understand what you're doing, and it actually resonates with them. So this is the real sauce. This is the same for getting copywriting clients, guys. There are so many of the dumb outreach messages. Ben, got a minute? No, I don't have a minute. And like, I know these people are trying, and you could play the volume game. There's nothing wrong with that, but I still recommend having a better tone of voice with it and a better, like, don't be a weirdo. But you could also just be really genuine with someone. Love your brand. I'd like to write you some free stuff. That's how I got my first really big client who paid me a shit ton of money. I wasn't weird about it. I was just like, hey, really like what you're doing. Can I write something for free for you? So that ended the conversation that they were having in their head, which is, oh, we do need this. And this person likes the brand. Yeah, I'll take a look. So that's kind of it, guys. The two things, be a student of markets. Become a student of markets. Read the Boron letters for that. And then enter the conversation that the prospect or your audience is already having in their own head. That's how, when they stumble across your brand or your product, they'll be like, oh my gosh, like, this is literally what I was looking for. I didn't even know it. So please drop a like if you made it this far. Drop a comment. Appreciate you. Peace.